and currently assistant professor at Maldives National University, Department of Sharia and Law. Dr. Mursalin got his bachelor, if not mistaken, from Madinah in Hadith, and then pursue his master's at IUM, and then his PhD from University of Malaya. He is my dear brother. He is the perfect scholar to talk about our topic today, the miracle of Al-Quran. And Alhamdulillah, tonight is our 17 Ramadan, of course, where Al-Quran is being bring down to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So without further ado, we invite our dear beloved brother, Dr. Mursalin, to deliver the tazkira on miracle of Al-Quran. Okay, brother.
Thank you so much. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salam ala ashraf al-mursaleen. Sayyidina Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanaka Allahumma la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal 'alimul hakim. Allahumma rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Allahumma rabbi zidna 'ilma. Allahumma rabbi zidna 'ilma. Allahumma rabbi zidna 'ilma. Alhamdulillah. It's my privilege to participate in this the program. Mashallah. Tibalaiti have started doing so much of work, alhamdulillah, so much of programs and so much of classes for the youth and then scholars, alhamdulillah, so many topics, and subhanallah, I used to participate in this program. Since mashallah, newly established the new team, alhamdulillah, in Malaysia and South Asia, so alhamdulillah, the whole team is working very well, alhamdulillah. My thanks goes to them, alhamdulillah, especially my appreciation and thanks goes to our beloved brother and then Ustad Shahran, alhamdulillah, and then the whole team of the IIIT, alhamdulillah, those who are to those who are working hard toward the successful of the IIIT, the thanks goes to them, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, this was a good opportunity to participate in this program and then to share with you all some of the information, some of the knowledge that I've learned from the great scholars. And alhamdulillah, as mentioned, our beloved Ustad Shahran, that tonight we are in the 17th of the Ramadan, and subhanallah, it's the Ramadan has gone very quickly and very fast. We hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may accept our fasting, and then that the prayers that we prayed, and then all the sadaqah that we have done, all the good deeds that we have done, so that may we forgiven from all our sins that we did all this along these years or these past months. Alhamdulillah, the great topic that I was given, that Mu'jizat al-Qur'an or I'jaz al-Qur'an, the miracles of the Qur'an. So, alhamdulillah, even though my specialization in the Qur'an and related to Qur'an and science of the Qur'an, alhamdulillah, that was a good chance and to talk about this issue. Even though I'm very fluent in Arabic language, but alhamdulillah, I hope so, inshallah, that I may contribute some kind of information that I from the Arabic language to and in English, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, as we know the Quran is a mu'jiza. Allah has sent this Quran, it's 14 centuries ago. That this Quran has sent down to our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through the Jibreel alayhi salam from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and through the Jibreel alayhi salam to the our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then this Quran has been revealed in 23 years. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, since he started his da'wah of Islam, conveying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya ayyuhar rasul balligh ma unzila ilayk. So he was revealing and he was conveying the message of Islam, the message of peace to the whole human being, the whole humanity. So the Quran has come to the human being as a guidance. So in that guidance, there was so much of miracles. It's not a miraculous of the science and technology. It's not a miraculous of the creations of a human being. It's not a miraculous of the how the heaven created, or the earth, or the how it's been created. It's not on the all the only few things, but in the, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran, ma farratna fil kitabi min shay'in, we haven't left anything, we have included, we have info, we have brought everything included in the, this Quran. So that's why, subhanallah, when we started looking at this, the scientists, how they discovered, how they realized in the few years back about the Quran, the reality of the Quran, the science of the Quran, the miracles of the Quran. When they went through the creation of the baby, in the womb of the woman, the janin fi batni ummihi, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَةَ فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَةَ عِظَامًا فَكَسَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ لَحْمًا فَأَنْشَأْنَاهُ خَلْقًا آخَرَ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. Subhanallah, when we go through this verse, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe the human being creations, how and then when you go through the some of the how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the actually the Quran, as we know, it's been revealed in the 7th century. So the Quran, when the Quran has been sent to the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then it was conveyed, the message of the Quran has been revealed to those Arab who were living in the 7th century. So we know that they were not having any kind of information, any kind of knowledge about this, what Quran has been talking, what Quran has been telling about the its miracles. Because we know that we have in the Quran, we have we can identify it easily, that in the Quran we have the four division of the, or five division of, or five types of the mu'jiza. We may say it, one is that Allahumma salli alayhi, we have i'jaz al-ilmi. So i'jaz al-ilmi, so it's the meaning of the i'jaz al-ilmi, that scientific miracles. So the Quran has includes so much of information. One of these scientific miracles, it refers to all the scientific references mentioned in the Noble Quran that indicate the uniqueness of the God Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the accuracy of his creation. The facts of scientific miracles found in the Holy Quran include the phenomena of astrology, human creations, natural phenomena, and the creation of animals, including many scientific facts that were absent from people, and it's been discovered by scientists a while ago, or maybe a few years ago. So we have so many things that have been discovered by the scientists. For example, when Maurice Bucaille, when he wrote his book, when he compared between the Quran and the science and the Bible, and he came to the conclusion is that the Quran is a perfect one that included everything. It's not only the miracles of the science of the miracles, but it's included all the types of the miracles. It's not in the Quran, not in the scientific miracles, but it's all types of the miracles that the Quran has been mentioned or stated. So he stated that in his book, Al-Quran wa Tawrah, Al-Ilmu, Al-Quran, Al-Ilmu wa Tawrah. Tawrat, if you're not mistaken. So he mentioned that how Quran, even though it has been sent in the 7th century, but subhanallah, it included everything, all type of the miracles. So that was the one of his remarks that been said by Mr. very famous scholar in France, Mr. Maurice Bucaille. And then we have one of the types of the miracles of the Quran, and we do have another types of the miracles of the Quran, legislative miracles. It is the supremacy and accuracy of the legislation, regulation and principles that the Noble Quran mentioned, and its distinction from the statutory legislation and ruling that are written in it in a way that it's impossible for human beings to follow. So when we go through the legislations of miraculous, which has been mentioned in the Quran, we see, especially when you go to the hudud, hudud, for example, qisas, and then sariqa, and then the hudud of the sariqa, the stealing, and then hudud of the adultery. So when you go through these kind of hudud, and we identify that the miraculous of the Quran, subhanallah, included so much of information that any kind of legislation have been created or implemented by the human being, there is a shortage. It's not an appropriate rules and regulation, because we know that, for example, for instance, we can see the human rights, those who are talking about the human rights, and then women's right, all these rights, those who are talking about the rights, even we can say the United Nations or from any other the organization that talking about the rights and regulation, all these human rights, when you see them, they are implementing those who are supporting them, those who are with them. But the one who, for example, they are not who do not have a power and who do not have a voice to raise their voices, so that we can find there is a discrimination. For example, we can say what has happened to the Palestinians. Even human rights, the United Nations, they have the powerful articles number 3 and the 19 and the number 92, article number 93. All these are regulating and saying that each human being are created same, equally, and then they have to get their rights equally. But once the issues of the Palestinians, of the Kashmir, all these Muslim issues, and they don't want to implement that rights. They may give the independence for the East Timor very quickly, but they cannot give the independence for the Kashmir people. So when you go through this kind of regulation that been created by the human being, we knew that when you compare the miraculous of the Quran, which stated the legislative the sector of the legislation, the Quran, we can easily find the differences, what has mentioned in the Quran, and then what has mentioned, what has created by the human being. So there's a shortage. So that's why even the scientists, those who are not Muslims, they identified the words of all the words, even the single word of the Quran are not from the Prophet Muhammad, it's from the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even though there was so much of claims that they were saying that, you know, it's a word of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we can see in some of the articles, some of the books that have been written by the Orientalists, and they're claiming even though they haven't studied very well in the Arabic language to go through very accurately, but they start claiming that these words, the Quran, is from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But nowadays, alhamdulillah, the scientists have proved that all the single words are from the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That all the rules and regulation, let's say it's the scientific issues, or let's say the legislative issues, or let's say the rhetorical issues. So the way that they came to conclusion is that this the Quran is not from Muhammad. It's not the Bibles have been changed. Quran is not being changed. It is as it is, as it's been revealed since the 7th century, and until now, it is the same verses, same Quran that came sent down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So easily we can identify them when it comes to the legislation miraculous. So we can identify that the human being legislation are short. There's shortage. It's not perfect. Sometimes they can implement some rules. For example, those who are done the adultery, or those who are did the sarita, the stealing, the punishment for the thieves. But it's not a perfect punishment. So this is one of the master miracles in the Quran, which is I mentioned the legislation. Okay, let's go to the another types of the miracles. It's that the metaphysical miracles. It's meant by the Quran's reference to unseen matter that have a relationship to the past, present, or future that it is impossible for human being to predict. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mentioned in the Quran, one of the miracles of the Quran is that it has mentioned everything, the past, how the Thamud, the nation of the Thamud, or the Salih, or the Qawmunu, how the people were in those days. The Quran has brought everything very sharply, without any kind of suspicious issues, because as we believe the Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned in his book, the Quran al-Karim, how what happened to the Musa alayhi salam's generation, what happened to the Isa alayhi salam generation, what happened to the Ibrahim alayhi salam generation, how he dealt with the people of the Namrud when he was a king, and then when Ibrahim alayhi salam started spreading the message of the Islam. So Quran, alhamdulillah, perfectly have mentioned what has happened in the past, and then also Quran has mentioned what is happening presently, how the issues, for example, nowadays we started talking about the problem in the ozone, what has happened, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran about this issue, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned how he raised he raised the sky and set the balance. Wasama rafa'aha, he is the one rafa'aha wa wada'a al-mizan. And then how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God is Allah is He who raised the heavens without any pillars, and then verily God is the one who holds the heavens and the earth lest they cease. So subhanallah, and then how the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned the Surah Al-Rahman, مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان. There is a two seas and the middle, subhanallah, barzakh. Subhanallah, one side is a pure water and then another side is a salt water. So nowadays they started identifying that what the Quran has mentioned, what Allah has mentioned in the Quran is perfectly true, very true. Barzakhul, na'am. So between the two seas. So, and then as also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that what is going to be happened, how the world going to end up, what are the things going to happen before that. So everything, mashallah, Allah has mentioned perfectly in the Quran, and then because of that we started calling that, you know, the Quran is a miracle. A Quran has consist of the different types of the miracles. So that is the third part. And then we do have the rhetorical miracles. One of the most important miracles of the Quran is that, because Quran has sent down to the Quraysh, the human being, and those days that the Quraysh were the eloquence, the master in the balagha, master in the fasaha. So they know they were the master in the poems. So even the Quran system, even when they started reading the Quran, they saw al-qari'atu mal-qari'ah, wa ma adraka mal-qari'ah. Then when you go to the al-haqqatu mal-haqqah, wa ma adraka mal-haqqah, kadhabat thamud wa 'adun bil-qari'ah. When they started seeing all this rhythm in the Quran, subhanAllah, when the Quran started noon, the end of, for example, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعْلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ. End of the lamb. Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi ashabil fil. Alam yaj'al kaydahum fi tadlil. وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. So subhanallah, Allah knew these Quraysh people are very eloquent, very fluent in Arabic language. So Allah has sent this Quran in their language. The Quran, even when Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala, in the last time when he collect the Quran together, so he said to all the Sahaba, the Zayd ibn Thabit and the group of the Sahaba, said, write the uktubuha bi lughati Quraysh. If there is any kind of issues in the language, uktubuha bi lughati Quraysh, write it in the Quraysh language. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran in the Arabic language, and the Arabic language was a very eloquent, very mashallah fasaha and clearly and rhetorically, mashallah, it was amazing. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sent the Quran to the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started reciting these Quranic verses to those Quraysh, and they started thinking it should be the poem. It's not a word of God. It's not a word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It should be the word of the human being. So that's why they said, it's a shi'r. Huh? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a sha'ir. Yeah? Innahu sha'ir. He's a poet. Because he's saying the poem, so he's a poet. So because the pattern of the Quran, they were thinking it's a poem. So that's why Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala denied he is not a poet. It's not a Quran. Is not a poem. It's from Almighty Allah. Innahu min Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked these people, those who are claiming that is not a Quran, not from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he challenged them by saying, "Qul Allahumma salli alayhi." Okay, so he said, "If you people are." Very eloquent, I mean, very famous in the poem and then in the balagha, all these things. If you are thinking that you have that capacity to bring this kind of Quran from yourself, do it. Bring it even one single verses. So that's why they started saying, so instead of the al-qari'atu mal-qari'atu wa ma adraka mal-qari'ah, they brought it al-filu mal-filu wa ma adraka mal-filu. لَهُ خُرْطُ مَطَانِ طَوِيلَتَانِ الْفِيلُ مَالْفِيلُ. You know, the alfil is the elephant. Alfil. Malfil. What is the elephant? وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَالْفِيلُ. Who make you to know what is the fil? What is the elephant? لَهُ خُرْطُ مَطَانِ. It has a two trunk. Then they started themselves laughing at themselves. Hey. Subhanallah, do you believe that this is the equal to this Quran, but Muhammad brought it? So they themselves created Alfilu, Malfilu, Wama Adraka, Malfilu, Laha Khurtumatani, Tawila Tani. then no, it cannot be. It cannot be the Quran. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them, قُلْ فَأْتُوا اللهم صلِّ عليه. Okay. So Allah says, قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِثْلِهِ. If you are people, have a guts to bring like this Quran, bring one surah, قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِثْلِهِ وَدْعُوا مَنْ. And then if we cannot bring one whole surah, one chapter, bring 10 verses of the one chapter. بِعَشِرِ سُورٍ مِثْلِهِ. If we cannot, بِسُورَةٍ مِثْلِهِ. So this is the what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned and has challenged them. If you have capacity to bring this kind of what do you call it? If you feel that the Quran is from human being, sent by created by human being, it's been done, it's come from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you do think like that, so you bring from your own self. So that we can believe that, you know, you have the guts to bring this Quran like this. Anyway, so these are some of the miracles, the four types of the miracles that we have mentioned. One is that the rhetorical miracles, which is about the ability of the meaning and various messages, which clearly, clarity and the rhetorical, that humans are incapable of replacing them. So the human being cannot replace the Quran by poem, any kind of things. So that is the number one. Number two is that scientific miracles. So we have mentioned that in a little bit. And then the third part is that legislative miracles, how Allah's word is a perfect and it's a suitable for every time, every place. It's not suitable in the period of the period of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not the period of Sahaba or Tabi'in or Tabi. It's longly. It's going to be for the day of until the last day of this dunya. And then we also have mentioned the metaphysical miracles, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran how the generation in the past were living and what happened to them, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them, what happened to the Ad and then his generation. When what is happening then nowadays, presently, how the scientists identified scientific way, how they prove that the Quran is not from the Muhammad, not from the human being, created by human being, but it's from the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a word of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then that was the past and then practice and then the present. And then the future also, how the dunya will be, how it is going to end up, how the sky will be collapsed, how the earth will collapse. So much of things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. So these are the miracles of the Quran has mentioned in the Quran. And then also there is the numbers. Some of the scholars have mentioned, they included the type of number five. They have mentioned that there is a five types of the miracles, and there's a numerical miracles in the Quran. Many scholars do not agree with this one, but I focus only the four types of the miracles. That's a very important and that very clearly can be identified in the Quran, in the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, the miracles of the Quran. So alhamdulillah, so what is the lesson that we can get from this small presentation from the humble person? So it says that Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not only for to reciting in our prayer. It's not only for to recite to get the thawab, the good deeds from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Rasulullah mentioned that, you know, Alif Lam is not a one word, it's a three letter. Alif is a, so you will get the, when you say Alif, is you get the 10 reward, and then Lam 10 reward, and then Mim also 10 reward. It's not only revealed for those type of, yes, definitely, we got, mashallah, we will get, alhamdulillah, thawab of this reward of this recitation of the Quran. But we have to identify, we have to realize that the Quran is talking to us. Miraculous, the Quran wasn't talking only the people, those who were in the period of Rasulullah, but it's talking to us. The miraculous of the Quran telling us, I'm still alive. I have, because I'm the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You come to me, you search about me, whatever you want in me, you will find so much of things in me. This is the word of the Quran. Say that you come to me. So when you search about the lots of things, as we mentioned, as our topic is the miracle of the Quran. So when you go through it, then that under the name of the miraculous, you will see so much of things, so much of information that Quran has given, inshallah, to identify about the Quran and how it is the Quran, what is the Quran, how it is revealed, what is the Quran, what the Quran is contained and consists of. Alhamdulillah. Thank you so much once again, and I thank the Ustad Shahran, alhamdulillah, for giving me this opportunity to share with you my humble knowledge, even though it's not a proper in a proper English, but please pardon me if there is any shortage. Inshallah, may Allah accept the minutes that we have spent listening this kind of small information, small sharing knowledge. So may Allah accept this time, and may Allah return in our mizan. To be rewarded in this month of in the holy month of Ramadan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Thank you so much, Doctor, for highlighting the miracle of the Quran, the scientific, the judicial, legislative, metaphysical, and the language. Doctor, at the third point, you said about the metaphysical, that Quran telling clearly what happened in the past. Like we read in the story of Yusuf, how the conversation between the brothers, the plotting to put him in the wells and everything. Can you explain a bit about this, they call it the Israeliyat, the stories that corrupting, and then Quran tried to clear it. What the stories, the real story is. Can you mention a bit about this Israeliyat?
Exactly, sir. Inshallah. MashaAllah. So, Quran, when you, subhanAllah, the Quran, as we mentioned, that it is very clear information. It gives a very clear information. There is a no doubt in even single word. So what happened in the when Rasulullah sallam when Rasulullah sallam was alive with the Sahaba, and when he was conveying the message of the Quran to the Sahaba, and there wasn't any problem. But what happened, some of the Jewish, mashallah, great scholars, they became a Muslim. So when they became a Muslim, so alhamdulillah, because the Israeli, when you talk about Israeli, we have the three divisions. One is that Maqbul, one is that Mardut, one is that La Nukadzib Wala Nusaddiq. What does it mean? That one is that Maqbul means acceptable, can be acceptable. Oh, what happened? Is there any evidence? Yes. Once upon a time, Rasulullah was talking, informing about the Dajjal. Rasulullah was guiding the Sahaba, who is Dajjal, how he would be, what is the shape of him, where he would be. So when he was talking like this, and then there was a Tamim al-Dari. He was the one of the great scholar of the Jewish, and he became a Muslim. And then, so he supported what Rasulullah has mentioned. So he supported in the Bible also, in the Torah, also has mentioned this issue. It will be like this. So Rasulullah was happy, and then he said, MashaAllah, someone, MashaAllah, you know, from the Ahlul Kitab, looks like even though Rasulullah does not need to his certification of the Tamim al-Dari, but alhamdulillah, he was very happy. So that is the science of the iqrar of Rasulullah sallam. So if there is no contradiction with the ta'limat deen Islam, the Islamic teaching and the Quran and Sunnah, so we can accept. That is the number one. Number two is that mardud. So what is the mardud? It cannot be acceptable. We cannot take it even for the to talk as a story. No, we cannot say that is a mardud, rejectable. Okay, is there any example? Yes. When we let's go to the surah Ahlul Kahf. So there is the Quran says five with the dog, six with the dog, seven with the dogs. So the Quran, mashallah, then rajman bil ghaib. So what happened? Some of we have Abdullah, one of the Allahumma salli wa barik alayhi. There was another scholar of the Jews. He became a Muslim, and then alhamdulillah, after passing the Rasulullah, when he went to meet the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he passed away, Rasulullah, so in the period of Sahaba, one of the person, I don't remember his name because it begins with the Abdullah. He started stating that this number of the Ahlul Kahf was more than like this, not to the seven or six like that. So he was bringing so much of issues, so much of things. So that when it had been said in front of the Sahaba, and then Rasulullah, the Sahaba didn't accept because it's contradict with the Quran, that the Quranic verse that came in the Surah Al-Kahf. So that is a mardud, and there we have some other issues also. And when you come to the la nusaddiq wa la nukadhib, we do not believe them, we do not tell them you are liar. La nusaddiq wa la nukadhib. We don't believe them, and we don't say that we don't make it as a lie story. So just keep silent, and we just capitalize it as it is. So when you come to the story of the Yusuf alayhi salam, so it's also that mashallah. So, some of the mufassirin, exegesists, so they brought in their tafsir. When they brought the issues of the Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, what happened? How the, because Yusuf alayhi salam, when he started saying in the Surah Yusuf, Inni ra'aytu ahada ashara kawkaban, wa shamsa wal qamar ra'aytuhum li sajideen. So when they saw the ahada ashara kawkaban planet making prostrating sujood, make sujood me. So when he went to telling to his father, Sayyidina Ya'qub alayhi salam, he said, La tafsus ru'yaka ala ikhwatika fayakidu laka kayda. So do not reveal what you have seen in your dream to your brothers. If you tell them, fayakidu laka kayda, they may make problems for you. They make kayd. So in this issue, regarding the issue of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, and how he was when he the issues of the when he was thrown into the well, and then some people came to take the King Aziz. He took the people who came to take him, and then he was the house of the Aziz, and the wife of the Aziz, the king of the Egypt. Wife of the Aziz, the king of the Egypt, she was telling to his husband, the king, let him, because they were not having a children. So she was started saying, let us have him as a son. So so the king of the Egypt, the husband of the king of the Egypt, he was saying that, okay, good, alhamdulillah. But the Yusuf alayhi salam, he was very, mashallah, beautiful. That's why Rasulullah said, Yusuf alayhi salam has given the half of the beauty of the dunya. He was very pretty. So that's why the wife of the king started, as a human being, we are human beings. We are not woman or not a male or female, far from the this kind of intention. We are human beings. Allah said, because of that, Allah has given us that to make a tawbah. So this Imratul Aziz, the wife of the king, and started approaching to do something. So Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam was not ready to do that one. Allah saved him, alhamdulillah. And then the king also realized that. So in this issue, they, the Israeliyats, brought so much of lies issues, lies stories about Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, how it was, it has happened. And then they explained even the name of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَقَالَتْ إِمْرَأَةُ الْعَزِيزِ. إِمْرَأَةُ الْعَزِيزِ. Allah never mentioned that her name is Zulaykha. Never mentioned. Even Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has never mentioned that, you know, the wife of the king name was Zulaykha. Never mentioned. So these people are mentioning the Zulaykha, and then what happened to Zulaykha, how Zulaykha was trying to get Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. So it, here also there is a certain issues that Israeliyat. So in this issue, it's a mardut. We cannot accept those the type of the story, the Israeliyat, that the narration of the Israeliyat that they have brought. And also when he was put in the jail, there is also some issues, the Israeli narrations there. Some of the, especially the Imam, many scholars, many the Mufassirin, they have brought Israeliyat. So we have to be aware of this kind of Israeliyat, not to go deeply, because if Allah wants to inform us, tells us, He would have mentioned. He would have mentioned in the Quran, subhanAllah, He mentioned the name of the subhanAllah, the Dhulqarnain and the Luqman. Already, if he wanted to say that, he would have mentioned the Quran, but he didn't. So it means that that's what Rasulullah said. So don't go for la tukadibuhum wa la tusaddiquhum. Don't believe them, do not make them liars. So just listen to them just like that, but do not reveal this kind of stories. So hope I answered, sir.
Thank you so much, Doctor, for that very nice explanation. And one thing that I heard from one scholar, that the Quran also quoted the enemy of Islam words in the Quran, which is rarely the author will do that. Like all this kafirun, what they said, and they will do in the Quran also, mashallah.
Yes, sir. Very true, sir. Very true. As, even when Allah, when the Surah Abasa wa Tawalla, sir, what happened? Yes, so even when Rasulullah was condemned by his action, because Rasulullah was conveying the message of Islam to the leader of the Quraysh, and he was busy with the conveying the message of Islam to them. Sure. But Abdullah ibn Maktub came, he was a blind Sahabi. So he came to, and then, Ya Rasulullah, allimni imma allamaka Allah, teach me what Allah has taught you. Then Rasulullah was not listening, because Rasulullah wanted to somehow to deliver the message of the Quran, message of Allah, to them, make them to become Muslim. So once he, Rasulullah was busy, and then looks like ignored the calling, the saying of the Abdullah bin Maktub, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a surah because of him. Abasa wa tawalla an ja'ahu al-a'ma. Yes, sir.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, doctor, thank you. Thank you so much. We give you another 5 minutes to conclude, doctor.
Alhamdulillah. First of all, I thank, mashallah, thank you so much. Thank you. I would like to thank the organizer, the IIIT, and then especially our beloved Ustad Mr. Shahran, and then the whole team of the IIIT. And then secondly, that alhamdulillah, I hope alhamdulillah the program is alhamdulillah will continue, and then even the classes also will be continued, inshallah. Yes, alhamdulillah, as we were alhamdulillah in the previous month, alhamdulillah. And then my conclusion is that alhamdulillah, the Quran has sent from Allah subhanahu sent down to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mashallah. It has a varieties of the miracles. Not only the scientific miracles, not only rhetorical miracles, not only metaphysical miracles, not only the legislation miracles. There is a lots of things we have to learn from the Quran, because it is the book of the guidance. It's a book of the guidance. The guide, the book of the guidance should guide the people, because Allah has sent the Quran as a guidance. So we should be led by this Quran. There won't be any kind of contradict words. So alhamdulillah, as we went through the all this type of the miracles, I'm sure that we have come across that, you know, alhamdulillah, how the Quran has elaborated or how describe the human being life, the scientific life, all this thing. Inshallah, we hope so. Inshallah, we could meet each other, inshallah, in the future, inshallah. Thank you so much. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Thank you. Thank you so much, Doctor. We'll see you in the next class, inshallah. The next opportunity, inshallah. Say our salam to all our friends in Maldives.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. We'll see you next. Tomorrow, we'll start at 5:45. Brother Ahmad Shiozaki from Japan will be with us, because the iftar time is 5:30 Malaysia time. So he will have iftar first, and then he will join us, inshallah. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.